Sometimes he travels from coast to coast, spreading news about the Holy Ghost. On a cloudy day, he brings some sunshine in. He's thumb out his Bible in his other hand, telling folks how to reach the promised land. They call him the traveling preacher man. Not very wealthy, but he's rich indeed. And you can be his friend if you'll only heed and sing it. Da 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 la la. Jesus wants you for his own. Da 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 la la. Praise the Lord, we're going home. Sing it. Da 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 la la. Jesus wants you. Yes, he really wants.
I want the people to know that he saved my soul, but I still like to listen to the radio. They say rock and roll is wrong, we'll give you one more chance. I say I feel so good, I gotta get up and dance. Woo! I know what's right, I know what's wrong, I don't confuse it. And all I wanna know is why should the devil have all the good music? I feel good every day because Jesus is the rock and he rolled my blues away. They say to cut my hair, they're driving me insane. I grew it out long to make room for my brain. But sometimes people don't understand what's a Christian doing in a rock and roll band? There's nothing wrong with the flatted third or the basic blues licks. All I wanna know is why should the devil have all the good music? I feel good. I've been filled. I feel okay. Oh, wow. I ain't knocking the hymns. Just give me a song that has a beat. I ain't knocking the hymns. Just give me a song that moves my feet. I don't like none of those funeral marches. I ain't dead yet. Jesus told the truth. Jesus showed the way. There's one more thing I'd like to say. They nailed him to the cross and they laid him in the ground, but the shooting on you can't keep a good man down. Woo! Praise God, you know Jesus is a rock and he rolled my blues. Jesus is a rock and he rolled my blues. Jesus is a rock and he rolled my blues away.
The focal point of our gathering together here this afternoon is here in this bread. We've come together to share, and part of the sharing and the hospitality that you read in the Bible focuses around this rather mystical substance that we call bread. And bread in the Bible has a mysticism and a spiritual significance in most of its references. Jesus took bread and broke it, gave it to his disciples and said, every time you eat this bread, you remember my death. Now, we're not having a Holy Communion service such as would be held in an established church around the world with bread and wine as our Lord instituted. We're more thinking of ourselves as perhaps the feeding of the 5,000 when Jesus took some loaves and thanked God, praised God, and distributed them to the people. And they all had a ball. They had a good time. They were fed. They were fed materially. They were fed spiritually. And Jesus says this, I am the bread of life. No one coming to me will ever be hungry again. This bread is my flesh, given to redeem humanity. I am the true bread from heaven. The true bread from heaven. And as we look out on the world, and many of us here will be in this festival for Jesus next week, there'll be thousands of people, many of them hungry people, hungry not for this bread, but for the true bread, which has come down from heaven. Now, it's possible for men and women to be hungry and never find food, and so they die. And all around us, there are people who are hungry for God, but they may never find the true bread. And the festival for Jesus and everything that we seek to do is an opportunity of holding out the bread and saying, this is the true bread. Come, take, eat. We're going to pass the bread around, take it and share it amongst yourselves. And perhaps look at it and break it and think of the broken body of Christ and think of what the world is asking for us. And now we're going to hear a bit from Nigel about this great festival for Jesus that's taking place up in the Big Wicked City next week.
For the festival, this is meant to be a day of preparation. And I'd like to share something with you, because this is the verse that the group of people who came together and sort of prayed over this festival, they thought this would be a good verse for today. God says this to Solomon and to all the people. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, and I will forgive their sin, and will heal their land. And really, that's what the festival for Jesus is all about. It's not about a religion, it's about a person and a relationship with that person. It's about Jesus. It's a festival of celebration, God's people singing about the Lord. It'll be a miracle, because it'll be God's work and not ours. It'll be nothing to do with us at all. It'll be all to do with him and with Jesus. And I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to a fantastic celebration feast in the festival for Jesus.
Procession of boats on the river, and we're going to have a meeting and a festival on Tower Hill right here. And we want you to know that these things are going to happen, because if you're not here next Thursday, you'll just kick yourself. 5 o'clock, come here after work and enjoy some good music, enjoy some happy people. There's a lot of despair and a lot of defeat in people's lives. There's a lot of pain in people's lives. And we want you to know that in the name of Jesus, there is victory even for your situation. I don't know how bad your situation is. I don't know how bad you've been, how immoral you are as a person. All I know is this, that in the name of Jesus, there is victory for the person who turns to him.
I don't need a life hereafter. I don't need a praying or some mythical God or Jesus.
What about food? You eat food, don't you?
I'm an animal. I'm a human animal.
You're dependent on food, aren't you?
But there's another thing. Yeah, but I'm not depending on any mythical support that you have.
How do you know it's mythical?
Well, because I can't. I wouldn't. How can I try it? I don't try something I don't even recognise.
I don't know whether you've got the wrong idea about Christianity and about the Lord Jesus.
Jesus Christ is dead, 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 dead.
But we we were speaking to him just a few moments ago, and he's not even sick.
Rubbish.
I'm sorry for those of you who say that he's dead, because you just want to know the reality that there is in God. And what is more, we'd like you to know that when Christian people are together and they've all got the Spirit of Jesus Christ, that that makes them one, that there is a unity of love and of joy and of peace.
By our love, yes, they'll know we are Christians.
I feared it would be my hard lot to announce the greatest military disaster in our long history. The whole root and core and brain of the British Army seemed about to perish upon the field. This struggle was protracted and fierce. Suddenly, the scene has cleared. The crash and thunder has, for the moment, but only for the moment, died away. A miracle of deliverance is manifest to us all.
Dunkirk, in a sense, as an actual event, doesn't mean very much to me, except what was passed on to me by my parents. But I do feel that the freedom that we have in this city today, and what we ought to be telling this city today, is because God is a miracle-working God. And the same God that brought men off the beaches of Dunkirk wrought a great miracle in 1940. 1 week before that miracle, our country was called to prayer by the late King George VI, the Queen's father. 32 odd years ago, the people of Britain were prepared to go to the chapels and the churches and the assembly halls of their land and were prepared to get down on their knees and turn to God in prayer for their nation. What did God do? Because his people turned to him. God didn't save our nation rather than save the German nation, because our nation was any better than the German nation. Not at all. Our God does not favor one nation or one person as against another person. Not at all. Our God, through his Son, loves all men and longs that all men will be united with him through the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. But our God loves righteousness, rightness, goodness, purity of heart and mind. And because the people of God turned and repented and cried out to him, he saved 335,000 men off the beaches of Dunkirk in 1940. God of 1940, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, is the same miracle-working God, and he longs to pour out his Spirit upon his people today. He longs to bring them to the Lord Jesus Christ, that Jesus may cleanse them and heal them by the power of his Spirit, and may present them perfect and acceptable to his Father. Oh God, that our nation may turn from being a sin bin to a salvation city.
What do you think of the Jesus movement?
So what? It's interesting.
No, I'm not bothered.
Seems a bit of a waste of time to me.
No comment.
That's a marvellous thing, really. Yeah, it's really.
Amazing grace.
fears relieved. How precious tears.
Years, bright shine.